Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and today Apple released iOS 15.0.2 to the public. This is available to everyone at the same time all around the world and is available on all iOS 15 supported devices. So if you have an iPhone 6S, 6S Plus, SE, iPhone 7, all the way up to the iPhone 13 Pro and 13 Pro Max, you'll have the update available now. Apple also released this alongside iPadOS 15.0.2. So if you have a supported device, such as an iPad Air 2 that I have here, all the way up to the latest iPad Pro or iPad Mini, you'll have a supported device and can install that now. Also, they released watchOS 8.0.1 to go along with this. And if you're not seeing the update, you can easily check for the update by going to Settings, then go to General, then Software Update, and you'll see the update. Now, if you're not seeing the update, turn off automatic updates and then check again, and you should see the update. However, if you're on iOS 15.1 betas, you won't see the update as you'll actually have a newer version on beta and you won't have this update available. And so you may have already seen the size of this, where it was 531.4 megabytes. That's on the iPhone 12 Pro Max, and on the iPhone 13 Pro Max, it was similarly sized at 589.4 megabytes. So it's a 500 to 600 megabyte update, depending on which device you have. And let's go ahead and take a look at the build number, and then we'll talk about what's new. So we'll go to Settings, then we'll go to General, then About, and you can see the build number is 19A404. And this particular build brings a bunch of bug fixes and updates to the latest iPhones and older iPhones as well. Now, currently there's no modem update, so if you're coming from iOS 15.0.1 to 15.0.2, you won't have a modem update, so don't expect any differences between connectivity, whether that be cellular, 5G, or LTE. There's really not going to be any differences there, at least based off the modem update. But there are a bunch of bug fixes in this update. And the first thing has to do with messages. So if you go into messages, and I'll go into one I sent to myself, and maybe you have some photos that you saved to your photo library. Maybe you want to save this one, we'll save it. And in your photo library, it would be there until maybe you deleted the message conversation or the conversation within messages. It would delete that from your photo library. Apple has now fixed that. So if we go back to our messages, under messages, if I slide and delete this conversation, prior to this, there's a bug that could delete all of your photos within those messages from your photo library. That has since been fixed. Now, Apple also fixed an issue with the new MagSafe leather wallet with Find My. So if you have this wallet and you have it attached to your phone, and then maybe you leave it behind, it should notify you if you leave it behind. Sometimes it wouldn't connect to Find My properly. And you'll see now it's popping up telling me to add this. I had a bug where it wouldn't show up, and then I couldn't add it to Find My. So that was a problem before. So what you do is you just hit continue and then add it to Find My. Prior to this, it just wouldn't show up properly on my devices. Now it's working properly, and you can use Find My to locate it. Also, there was another issue in Find My if you're using AirTags. So if you have an AirTag and you're trying to locate it in Find My, so we'll go into Find My. Within Find My, sometimes it just wouldn't show up properly in your items tab. So if you're using Find My and AirTags, now they should show properly and you'll be able to play a sound or find it nearby or anything like that. Before this, you may have had an issue doing that from any of your devices. Now, something else they've resolved in this update, I think a lot of people will be very happy about if you use Apple CarPlay. Prior to this, you could have issues where CarPlay may fail to open audio apps or disconnect during playback. So whether you're playing music, whether you're in a music app or something else, and it was playing back, I heard a lot of reports where it would just stop and not properly work. So if you're playing any music, it would just stop automatically. And it didn't really seem to matter the vehicle that you're using CarPlay with. It was a problem across all devices. I heard this over and over, and this has been resolved, and hopefully the major bugs with CarPlay are fixed. It will take a little time to know if it's fixed for everyone, but they should be resolved with this update, and it's been problematic since the original release of iOS 15. Now, along with this, if you're restoring your device when you're using Finder or iTunes, so if you're on a Mac, you'll use Finder and it will look like this. And if you're restoring an iPhone, you could have an issue before with the iPhone 13 models. So maybe you're restoring an iPhone 13, 13 mini, iPhone 13 Pro, or iPhone 13 Pro Max. There could be a message that it failed when you were trying to update it or restore it. That has been resolved in this update. Now on the iPad, you have similar issues that have been resolved. There's not much different there at all, but the one thing they did resolve specifically again has to do with Finder or iTunes on the iPad mini 6th generation when you're trying to restore or update your device. So prior to that, you could have a failure message where it should work properly now. Why it's only on the newest devices is hard to say. There is not an update on the Mac side to resolve that. So if you're restoring your iPhone 13 or basically anything that Apple just released, that should now be resolved properly. Now there was also a touch bug on the iPhone 13s that has been resolved, and the problem seemed to stick around for YouTube. The YouTube app was updated just this past day or so, and it resolves that touch bug as well. So now all of the touch issues seem to be resolved on iPhone, whether that be opening an app, simply opening Home or something else. And if you're going into maybe weather or another application, sometimes you would just touch and it wouldn't do anything. That was resolved earlier on, but it still remained in YouTube and it seems to be resolved due to that YouTube update. So check for updates in your App Store if you're having that problem. One thing I noticed right away once this updated is that my widgets loaded right away as well. Some people were having issues where the widgets would not show properly. While that was supposed to be fixed in iOS 15.0.1, it seems to definitely be fixed now. Right when I booted up the iPhone 7, it was blank and then it immediately filled in. The same is true with the iPad. So it looks like they've fixed the widget refresh issue. Now, as far as how often it refreshes is hard to say, but it does look like they've fixed that. Now there's a power sleep wake issue where some people were seeing delays when turning on their phone, and that seems to be resolved in this update as well, although they don't say that it's fixed specifically. I've had some people tell me already, if you powered on your phone, sometimes there was a delay. It seems to be nice and fast with this update. Now, Apple did resolve one storage issue that was there with iOS 15 in iOS 15.0.1, where there was a message that you had no available storage left. However, there's still a storage bug that seems to exist that people are still experiencing. I asked on Twitter whether or not people were still having this, and some people have excessive storage being taken up, and others show that maybe you have a 256 gigabyte iPhone and it says 300 gigabytes is available. It's showing odd storage messages here and there, and some people can't see this at all where it just won't load. So it really depends on the phone. I've seen multiple people say they have no issues and others say that they still do, but it's not resolved in iOS 15.0.2. Now, along with the resolved issues and updates, Apple has also patched some security updates. So as you can see on the security website, I'll link it in the description, but you can see it says iOS 15.0.2 and iPadOS 15.0.2. If we go into this, you'll see what was actually patched, and it says IO mobile frame buffer. And the impact was an application may be able to execute arbitrary code with kernel privileges. Apple is aware of a report that this issue may have been actively exploited. To fix it, or the description, a memory corruption issue was addressed with improved memory handling. Now, this may not be the only security update in here. It's just the only one they mention. So that's been patched in this update. Now, as far as the overall battery life of this update, well, it always takes a few days to know for sure, but I would not expect any major differences compared with the prior update. And so I've been running iOS 15.0.1 and iOS 15.1 betas on this iPhone 13 Pro, and you'll see when I ran it early on, I had 3 hours and 14 minutes of screen on time, 50 minutes of screen off time, with about 50% of my battery used. So if I was to use this to 100% of my battery, I could expect the normal 7 to 8 hours of screen on time with pretty decent screen off time as well. It just varies day to day, but in general, the update seems to be pretty stable for most, and I did a follow-up about that, where many people said it was much better. A few people did have some issues though. Now, as far as overall performance, it does seem to be performing quite well. I noticed it was quite smooth on all of the devices here, and on the iPhone 7, it was nice and fast right away after it was done processing in the background. And so if we go into things like music, you'll see that we can scroll pretty smoothly here. It is a little choppy, but that's pretty typical of this device. And the nice thing is it did not seem to be warm at all. After booting up and initially installing the update, the back of the phone was warm, but not hot like it was with 15.0.1. So there's definitely an improvement there, at least on the iPhone 7. All of the phones were fairly cool to touch, which was an improvement over the previous update. So there was definitely a difference there, and that's a great improvement, and hopefully it's better for you as well. And so that leads me to, should you install iOS 15.0.2? And I would say absolutely, just for the security updates alone. Of course, if you're already on 15, 15.1 betas, you won't be able to install this, but you would have to use a computer to downgrade to it. But if you wanted to try a beta, I would probably hold off. I would wait until 15.1, either release candidate or the final version. But if you want to try 15.0.2, I would highly recommend it, as it has that security update and of course those other bug fixes as well. Now, as far as the release of iOS 15.1, well, I would expect a beta or release candidate as soon as tomorrow or Wednesday. Last week we had beta 3, so I would expect beta 4 or release candidate very soon, with a final release within the next few weeks. It's expected that Apple is going to have an October Apple event to show off new Macs, and so maybe we'll see it sometime around then with a new macOS Monterey release, since we haven't seen that yet. So within the next couple of weeks, I would expect iOS 15.1 with some new features and bug fixes as well. And so as far as everything else in iOS 15.0.2, that's everything. And of course, if you found anything else or noticed anything different, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.